The methodology that is required is one which was taught by my teacher of blessed memory, Mawlana Fazlur Rahman Ansari Rahimahullah. And if you do not have the proper methodology, don't bother. You're not going to arrive at the correct conclusion. This methodology has been explained several times in the past, and tonight we should not spend too much time repeating what we have done in the past, except to say that you do not take any verse of the Quran in isolation, and do not take any hadith in isolation by itself to try to get knowledge and make judgment, because sometimes you can be wrong. The proper methodology requires that you do homework. The proper methodology is to collect all the data pertaining to the subject, first from the Quran, and when you acquire that from the Quran, you must bring them together in a harmonious whole, integrated whole. And for that you have to discover what he calls a system of meaning. And that's not a task for boys. You need to have a high status in knowledge to be able to locate the system of meaning of a subject in the Quran. And then you move to the Hadith. And then you integrate into the body that you have those ahadith which are harmonious with that system of meaning. And so your body of data will be constantly growing. All of this from the Quran and all of these coming from the Hadith. And when you get a Hadith which is in conflict, in conflict with all that you have acquired from the Quran, from the Hadith, you ignore that Hadith. Ignore it. And so when Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam has referred to a city by name, as he had on Constantinople, he has referred to the city of Constantinople by name in Arabic, Constantinia. These words came out of his blessed lips, Constantinia. So when you find a hadith which indirectly is referring to the city, and you have to interpret it to be Constantinople, you know, this is not in conformity with what I call the literary sunnah. The literary sunnah, that there is consistency. If the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam is constantly referring to the city by name, how come over here he speaks about the city and does not mention the name? And this is why when I deal with the subject of Constantinople, don't come to me and tell me, oh, but there's that hadith. Why aren't you mentioning that hadith? Because over there you are interpreting that the city is Constantinople. So this is our methodology. And akhiru zaman